Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about in partnership accounts. Okay, na? Admission of a partner. Okay, na? Now I am explaining to you about admission of a partner. Okay, Nandi? Right. So now here. So now I am explaining to you about admission of a partner, right? So while new partner entering into a partnership firm, certain adjustments are required in partnership accounts. Okay, now while any new partner admitting into a partnership firm, then certain adjustments are required. So they are, one is revaluation of assets and liabilities. Okay, na? What is the first one? Revaluation of assets and liabilities. Second one is distribution of general reserve and accumulated profits and losses. Accumulated profits and losses. Next, the third one, valuation of goodwill and distribution of goodwill. Right? Valuation of goodwill and distribution of goodwill. Next, fourth one is adjustment of capitals. And fifth one is preparation of new balance sheet. Right? While new partner admitting into a partnership firm, certain adjustments are required. They are, one is revaluation of assets and liabilities. Second one is distribution of general reserve and profit and loss account, accumulated profits. Third one is valuation of goodwill and distribution of goodwill. So valuation of goodwill is different and distribution of goodwill is different. So thereafter, adjustment of capitals. So next one is preparation of new balance sheet. So these adjustments are required while new partner entering into a partnership firm, right? So first of all, I am explaining to you revaluation of assets and liabilities, right? So what is the first one? Revaluation of assets and liabilities. Revaluation of assets and liabilities. Right. So first of all, I am explaining to you about revaluation of assets and liabilities. So revaluation of assets and liabilities is here again classified into two types. When revalued figures, that means new figures shown in the balance sheet. Okay, Nandi? When revalued, that means new figures, means new values, revalued. Okay, na? Revalued assets and liabilities shown in the new balance sheet. It is called revaluation method. It is called, in simple words, revaluation method. When revalued figures, revalued values, new values, that means new values of assets and liabilities shown in the new balance sheet, right? So it is called revaluation method. So second one is, when revalued means revised values. Okay, na? Revised values not shown in new balance sheet. Okay, na? Right? Not shown in new balance sheet. It is called memorandum method. Memorandum revaluation method. Understood? Right? When revised values means new values. Okay, na? New values of assets and liabilities. When revised values of assets and liabilities shown in the new balance sheet is called revaluation method. Another one is, when revised values not shown in the new balance sheet. Understood point here? So revaluation of assets and liabilities is again classified into two types. One is called revaluation method. Another one is called memorandum revaluation method. Okay, now? Right. So first of all, I am explaining to you about revaluation method. What is that? Revaluation method. Right. So come to the point. Revaluation method. So why revaluation of assets and liabilities is necessary while new partner admitting into a partnership firm? Means, suppose for example, A and B are partners. You assume here, A and B are partners. They established their business, you assume, during the year 2015. Okay, na? A and B are partners. They established their business during the year 2015. Now, you assume during the year 2021. You assume now in 2021, they interested to admit a new partner in partnership form HC. Understood point here? A and B are partners. They established their partnership firm during the year 2015. Now, they want to admit a new partner in partnership firm. Okay, na? Suppose it is the 2021 year. You assume, right? So, while admitting C into a partnership firm, assets values and liabilities values as per the market value, they are different. So, that's why you revalue the assets and liabilities, right? Suppose, for example, land acquired during 2015, you assume for rupees 5 lakhs. So, obviously, generally, that land value will be increases. You assume that land value 8 lakh rupees, for example, right? So here, what is the land value? 5 lakhs. They purchased during the year 2015. Okay, na? Now, that land value, while new partner admitting it into a partnership firm, that land value is 8 lakh rupees. Means that land value increased here. How much value increased here? So land value increased by rupees 3 lakhs. By rupees 3 lakhs. How much amount increased here? 3 lakh rupees increases. Like that, suppose plant and machinery also purchased. They purchased plant and machinery. That plant and machinery purchased for rupees, you assume 2 lakhs. Plant and machinery purchased for rupees 2 lakhs during the year 2015. That plant and machinery value generally decreases because depreciable asset. It is the depreciable asset generally. It is the appreciable asset. Land is generally land and buildings are generally appreciable assets. So generally plant and machinery, furnitures, these are depreciable assets. So you assume that land value. Now, that plant and machinery value, you assume 1,50,000 rupees. That means 50,000 rupees decreases. 50,000 rupees decreases. Understood point here? So, while new partner admitting into your partnership firm, you revalue the assets and liabilities. So, that's why we are revaluing the assets and liabilities of partnership firm. So, first of all, I am explaining revaluation method. Under revaluation method, you have to prepare revaluation account. What is that? Revaluation account. Okay, na? So you have to prepare here revaluation account. So how to prepare revaluation account? Right. Okay. Right. So you assume it is the revaluation account. Right. So generally, profits, credit, losses, debit. Okay, right. So now here, suppose asset value increases means profit. Suppose asset value decreases means loss. Asset increased, profit. Okay, na? Asset decreases, loss. Like that liability. Suppose liability value decreases is profit. Liability value increases, that is loss. Understood point here? Asset value increased, profit. Decreased, loss. Liability value decreases, that is the profit. Liability value increases, that is loss. Understood point here? Alright, now come to the point. Profits are shown credit side generally. Losses means debit. So now here, any asset value increases. Okay, na? Shown. Okay, na? Credited to revaluation account. When any asset value increases, credited to revaluation account. Like that, any liability. Okay, na? Liability value decreases, credited to, okay, na? Revaluation account. right? So like that here. When any asset value decreases, loss debited to revaluation account. When any liability value increases, is also loss debited to revaluation account. That means here any asset value decreased, any liability value increased, debited to revaluation account. Any asset value increases, liability value decreases, they are profits credited to revaluation account, right? Now come to the point here. Land value 5 lakhs increased to 8 lakhs means increased by 3 lakh rupees. That increased value only, that increased value means that difference amount. So credited to revaluation account. So here write down by land rupees 3 lakhs. Okay na? So next thereafter, suppose plant and machinery value here decreased by rupees 50,000, earlier 2 lakhs, now 1.5 lakh rupee, means 50,000 rupees decreases. So then you write down to plant and machinery rupees here 50,000. When asset value decreases, that means that 50,000 debited to profit and revaluation account. Okay na? Asset increases, credit side. Liability decreases, credit side. Asset decreases, debit side. Liability increases, debit side. That means in simple words, losses debited and profits credited. Now the difference between debit side and credit side is distributed to old partners as per old profit sharing ratio. We should point here. Difference between debit and credit distributed to whom? Old partners as per old profit sharing ratio. Suppose credit side is more, debit side is less. That difference is called revaluation profit. The difference is called revaluation profit. Okay na? Then, okay na? That is distributed to partners as per their old profit sharing ratio. So transfer to partners capital account. Transfer to partners capital account. It is revaluation profit. Transfer to partners capital account. Okay, now it is the revaluation profit. Suppose loss is there. That is the credit side. That means debit side is more, credit side is less. That is called loss. Credit side is more, debit side is less, that difference is called profit, right? So that revaluation profit distributed to old partners as per old profit sharing ratio. Which profit sharing ratio? Old profit sharing ratio means in simple word old ratio. Old profit sharing ratio means simply you assume here that is old ratio, right? So suppose same transactions for entries okay na? Suppose asset value increases, then what is the entry? When asset value increases, then entry is asset account debtor to revaluation account. When asset value increases, asset account debtor to revaluation account, you write down individual asset name. So that's why you are credited. Suppose, for example, asset value decreases,
asset value decreases, then entry is revaluation account data or to asset account. When asset value decreases, revaluation account data to asset account. Like that. Liabilities. When liability value decreases, then liability account data to revaluation account. Understand point here? Like that. Liability value increases, then revaluation account data or to liability account. Right? So here, when asset value increases, asset account data revaluation account. Asset value decreases, revaluation account data to asset account. Liability value decreases, liability account data to revaluation account. When liability value increases, revaluation account data to liability account. Now, difference. Suppose revaluation profit is there. In the case of revaluation profit. So, in the case of revaluation profit, then entry is revaluation account data to partner's capital account. Which partners? Old partners. Okay, now. So, as per which ratio? Old profit sharing ratio. As per old ratio. Right. Suppose loss is there. Quite opposite entry. Suppose loss is there. In the case of revaluation loss. Then quite opposite entry. Quite opposite entry means partner's capital account. Partner's capital account. Which partners? Old partners. Capital account data to revaluation account. So as per which ratio? Same old ratio. Okay, Randy? As per old ratio. Right. So, in the case of profit, revaluation account data to partner's capital account as per old ratio, old partners. So, revaluation loss is there. Then, old partner's capital account data to revaluation account as per old ratio. It is the revaluation method. Right. That means, in this case, new values shown in the balance sheet. New values means, here, land value 5 lakhs increased to 8 lakh rupees. In new balance sheet, 8 lakh rupees shown in the balance sheet. Suppose plant and machinery value 2 lakhs. Now, decreased to 1.5 lakh. Now, in new balance sheet, shown 1,50,000. These are called revalued figures. These are called new values. New values shown in the balance sheet is called revaluation method. Right. Now, come to the point. Now, I am explaining to you second method. That is revaluation. That is a memorandum revaluation method. That means here, when revised values not shown in new balance sheet, That is called memorandum. Memorandum revaluation method. What is the memorandum revaluation method? Okay, right? So under this method, you have to prepare memorandum revaluation account. What is that? Memorandum revaluation account. Here you have to prepare memorandum revaluation account. So memorandum revaluation account is so it is a memorandum revaluation. It contains two parts. How many parts? Two parts. Part 1, part 2. It is part 1, it is part 2. Part 1 is called revaluation. Part 2 is the cancellation. Understand point here? Part 1, revaluation. Part 2, cancellation. Revaluation means same as is the old method. Right. Come to the point here. Suppose asset value increases credited to okay na revaluation account means here memorandum revaluation account in part 1. Next, liability value decreases, that is also profit credited here. Next, liability value increases is also loss debited. Suppose credit side is more, debit side is less, that is profit. So distributed to whom? Old partners, transfer to old partners, capital account. Suppose loss is there, credit side, profit is there, debit side, right? So distributed to old partners as per old profit sharing ratio. As per which ratio? Old profit sharing ratio. As per old profit sharing ratio. Or in simple words, you write down here, old ratio, right? So it is part 1. In part 1, as it is, it is the revaluation account. When asset increases, credit side. When liability decreases, credit side. When asset value decreases, debit side. When asset liability value increases, debit side. Suppose credit side is more, debit side is less, that is profit. Debit side is more, credit side is less, that is loss. Anyway, difference is distributed to old partners as per old profit sharing ratio, right? So now we distributed to old partners as per old profit sharing ratio. Now come to the point, it is called part 2. This part 2 is called cancellation part. Understood point here? Part 2 is called cancellation part. Now I am explaining to you about cancellation. So how to cancel? Very simple. All credit side transactions, now you write down debit side. Right? All credit side transactions, write down debit side. Now, all debit side transactions, write down credit side. Understood point? All these transactions, debit side. All these transactions here, credit side. That is called cancellation. That is called cancellation. Right. So, first of all, we cancel the revalued figures. So, that means here, 2. asset value increases. Now you write down debit side. Next, 2, liability value decreases. Now you write down, debit side. Like that, asset value decreases, write down now credit side. When liability value increases, write down credit side. Liability decreases, increases, asset decreases, credit. That means it is cancellation. Same values. Right? Now you cancel here. Right? Same values as it is. Now, automatically, here, now it shows debit side more, credit side less. Suppose, for example, earlier debit side, now that is credit side. Now you write down here, by all partners capital account. Which partners? All partners capital account. So here all partners means including new partner. All partner means including new partner is called all partners, right? So here cancel to all partners as per new ratio. Which ratio? New ratio. Understood point here? In part 1, old partners, old ratio. In part 2, all partners, new ratio. All partners, new ratio. Understood? So, as per new ratio, distributed to, cancel to all partners, including new partner. So, in this case, revised values not shown in the new balance sheet means old values we shown in the balance sheet. Old values shown in the balance sheet. Old values means, for example, just before I explained, land value 5 lakhs now increased to 8 lakhs. But in new balance sheet, you have to show, okay, now 5 lakh rupees, not 8 lakh rupees, right? Suppose plant and machinery value 2 lakhs, now decreased to 1.5 lakh rupees, but you have to show in the new balance sheet 2 lakh rupees. Because these are old figures. These are new figures. Under revaluation method, new figure. Under memorandum method, old figures shown in the new balance sheet. It is called the memorandum method. Right? So here, memorandum, that means when revised values not shown in the new balance sheet, means memorandum revaluation method. Under this method, you have to prepare memorandum revaluation account. How to prepare? Part 1, part 2. Part 1 as it is revaluation, part 2 is the cancellation. So, part 1 as it is revaluation means asset value decreased, liability value increased, debit side. Asset increased, liability decreased, credit side. Now, cancellation. Quite opposite you write down. Okay, na? In part 1, old partners, old ratio. In part 2, all partners means including the new partner is called all partners. Distributed, cancelled to all partners as per new ratio, means new profit sharing ratio. It is the first one, right? So thank you. In the next period, I will explain to you about distribution of general reserve and accumulated profits and loss account. Okay, right? Thank you.